A teenager from the U.S. state of Idaho is trying to become the youngest person to fly around the world solo. 19-year-old Matt Guttmiller is a student at MIT. He plans to make stops in 14 countries across 5 continents over a month's time. He'll be making at least 5 stops in Asia. It's quite a way to spend a summer vacation. He certainly will have bragging rights if this goes well. And he takes off very soon. But right now, he's joining us from San Diego, California. Thank you so much for joining us, Matt. So let's get right to it. When are you going on this trip, and why? How did you come up with this idea?
Sure. Well, I'm planning to leave Saturday morning from San Diego. And the thing that really just gave me the idea was about this time last year, I read an article about a kid from California that was going to do it. He ended up being 21, and I just kind of thought, gee, I could do that. And so I started planning it, put it together, and now I'm going to go do it.
So how long have you been flying, and what's the longest distance that you've ever flown?
I've been flying just under 3 years now. The longest flight I've done is from Austin, Texas to San Diego. That was about 7 hours, about 1,100 miles. Relatively short compared to some of the legs I'll be doing on this trip.
Yeah, I would say 7 hours compared to you're going to be flying for over a month's time, of course, different legs. Are you nervous?
You know, not really, at least not about the flying, at least right now, I guess. You know, the first time I get an hour out over the ocean, you know, and all I can see is blue, that might change a little bit. But, you know, right now I'm not really nervous about that. You know, just hoping that everything goes smoothly, you know, don't hit any little paperwork issues anywhere or something like that.
What do you think the biggest challenge will be for you?
You know, the biggest thing is probably just keeping a really close eye on the weather. That's really the biggest thing, or biggest difference, I guess, between doing something like this and just, you know, flying from, you know, San Diego to Austin or something, because, you know, on these, you know, like the longest leg I'll be doing is from Hawaii to San Diego, and that's about 14 and a half hours. You know, a lot can change with regard to the weather in, you know, when you're in the air for 14 and a half hours.
So you're a student at MIT, you're 19 years old. Who's paying for all of this?
So I'm raising money, and then all of the proceeds go to a nonprofit called code.org, and they work to put computer science education programs in K-12 schools. And so, you know, there's sponsorship opportunities available. People can put logos on the side of the plane, you know, go to our website, learn more, that kind of thing.
Very cool. So if you are successful, what's the first thing you're going to do upon reaching home?
You know, I don't know. I haven't even gotten that far. I'm just kind of focused on, you know, getting there right now.
And any idea what your next challenge is going to be?
You know, I don't. You know, it's just there's a lot to think about for about the next month or so, and I just haven't gotten past that yet.
I guess you will have plenty of time to think when you're flying up there all by yourself. So we wish you the very best. Please keep us posted, Matt, on your travels.
Thanks, and thanks for having me.